Finally, it's working. Imagine, with 1.5 kilowatt, you keep your whole house warm. Thanks to the storage, you can give also much more power for a limited time when you arrive in a cold house. This is the way to electrify your heating in the winter and cooling in summer. All seasons with one affordable do-it-yourself system. Isn't that incredible? In this video, you see that it's possible for a do-it-yourself. Hi, Norbert here, energy engineer and explaining in video number 71 how I finally connected the thermal energy storage with the heat pump to a central heating. This video is going to be short because I had not enough time, had to improvise experiments and plumbers were. The plumbers are so difficult to find. All the better, because now you can see how much you can do yourself. So I will tell now what I did this week. The results obtained, show a few images and footage, and all the details will be next week. The do-it-yourself passionate that wants to start a new project and to exploit the unique advantages of this system, they will be glad with the next week's video, full with all the details. And the other viewers, at least their curiosity that all this is real. Now to this video. Let's again see the advantages of this concept. First, double efficiency because of the employment of both heat and cold. Second, do-it-yourself gives you solutions that you cannot find on the market. Not even the heat pumps over 10 grand have the flexibility of this concept. And three, one system is good for summer and winter. That increases simplicity and it decreases investment. And then four, storage will allow to make better use of excess electricity. We had last week guests from Bulgaria in our zero energy holiday home. They told that after some years of good state support for home producers of solar electricity, with the new legislation, it's not convenient anymore to feed PV electricity into the grid. How's that in your country? Now you can store that energy in a very affordable storage solution instead of putting it into the grid. Put two heat pumps at work in two water boxes. In this way, you will co-generate cold and warm water, and therefore you will have double efficiency if you can use both. The water boxes will discharge in big water tanks. The warm water tank will give the heat to the radiators in the house, just by putting one of them into the warm water tank. Of course, the radiators in the house need fans because of the lower temperature compared to hot water radiators. If you remember the water box of the previous video, this is my alternative to take the heat from the heat pump heat exchangers. Two heat pumps in one system. I can use one of two heat pumps to moderate the rate of heat production. I had to cross the heat exchangers of one of them. Probably the cause for breaking a tube connection and losing the gas. I found a new idea to avoid icing of the evaporator, which reduced the overall COP, or the energy multiplication factor, to 2. I tried the shower for the heat exchanger instead of the bath. I had to close some holes of previous projects and Charlie gave me an idea. The COP is the coefficient of performance. If the COP is 3, then a heat pump with an electric power consumption of 500 watt, our case, will give 1500 watt of heat. I show you how to combine two or more of them in a modular way in order to consume all excess PV electricity under your command. Let's measure it again, but as a complete system with the big tanks. We will disregard the production of cold because it is becoming winter. You will see this measurement in the next video, because this video gives only the main points and results.
COP is measured with temperatures, liters and time. In my experiment, I did several improvements to keep the temperature of cold and warm parts close to each other. For example, by using the fact that warm water will rise and taking water from the right location. Also avoiding ice forming on the evaporator is important, as it will avoid the compressor to work very hard for nothing. Our COP in the whole system is 2.2, and with optimizations here and there, it can be better. For example, better insulation in water boxes and the big tanks, but also the ice on the evaporator, even with the cold tank at 10 degrees. That should not happen. I need only two pumps for the water exchange between water boxes and big tanks. The return is with gravity. I integrated this time also a flow meter to calculate the thermal power, because power is dependent from how many degrees you heat, how much water in how much time. I just cut the two tubes between the home radiator network and the boiler. Then I connected supply and return to my system with a new standard central heating pump. Instead of the boiler, I submerged a standard radiator in the warm water container as the new heat supplier. It will pick up the heat from 1000 liters at maximum 50 degrees Celsius and transfer it to the water that is sent into the house to the other radiators. Such a radiator has enormous transfer capacity if water is inside and outside. So if you add fans on the radiators at home, you can quickly discharge the heat of the 1000 liters into your home. And that's much more power than the heat pumps alone. I consumed much plumber's hemp and pasta. Better than Teflon or your own hair. I have to fill the whole radiator network with new water, and we'll do that by interrupting the circuit before the circulation pump. Then I will put one end on the tap, 3 bars pressure, while the other ends will drain into the containers. I will use a circulation or an external pump to add the special anti-corrosion product from a container where this additive is mixed in a bucket of water. Now we can start the new central heating circulation pump, and we see that it starts to send more than 100 liters per hour of lukewarm water of 30 degrees Celsius. Lukewarm because I broke one of the two heat pumps. Only 100 liters because there is certainly too much resistance in the water circuit for a small pump of 34 volt maximum. After 10 minutes, the warm water arrived at the central collector. I felt the difference with the return collector. Then it came also to the closest radiators. I'm aware of the many shortcomings in the system that you saw today. I just want to see it working. And it does. From here, I can improve the shortcomings one by one. I find it exciting that we can substitute a fossil fuel heating with an efficient renewable energy solution that can heat and also cool. And it is flexible enough to work on normal grid electricity. And the advantage here, that you can charge the water tanks with cheap off-grid electricity. And using that energy is also a benefit for the whole community. Talking about community, I think that we have to contribute in our way to the climate protection. Also, last 2 weeks, I heard about climate events that are really out of the statistic normality. We have to do our part as normal folks that embraces good innovation and do it yourself. If you don't feel comfortable with some do it yourself tasks, you can ask friends or the plumber if they are more around in your area than here. You can also contribute by subscribing to the channel, put your thumbs up and share the video. I am late with this video also because I cannot work full time on this channel as I would like. Coming Saturday,
I will show you the details of this project and you will see calculations. You will see me working as a plumber, and all plumbers at YouTube, I expect many comments. I will tell what I learned, what I improved on the system, and suggestion to improve it further if I had no time to do it in this video. The video will be much longer. By the way, sorry if some weeks the subtitles come with a delay after the publication of the video. I wish always to publish the video in the weekend with at least English subtitles in high quality. Then it will be easier to have also the other six languages in high quality, even if it is in automatic YouTube translation until the moment that I make these subtitles myself. I hope you feel empowered that also you can make a Unix system with cheap storage, water instead of lithium, double efficiency if you can use both heat and cold, in addition to the already high efficiency of heat pumps. Please come back on Saturday to see the details of what I learned, what I improved, and what I measured. I wish you good energy.